Hey, once you go, Ashanti Rashad reporting to you live with another video. If you're new to my channel, welcome. Please don't forget to turn on that bell notification and subscribe to my channel if you enjoyed today's video, as well as to follow me on social media. If you guys are returning subscribers, welcome back. I know you guys read the title, so without further ado, let's get into it.
Put out the song Nanya, and a lot of people were saying, okay, you know, August is dating Jada Pinkett Smith, and that was something that was circulating as a rumor, and that kind of solidified it to people. So what was the real situation with Jada Pinkett Smith? Because I don't know if you were pursuing her or you guys had just a close family type of relationship, and I would love for you to be able to shed that.
Here's what I'll say. People can have whatever ideas that they like, but what I'm not okay with is my character, you know, being in question. When certain things are questionable that I know is not me, or that I know that I haven't done, you know, contrary to what some people may believe, I'm not a troublemaker, you know? I don't like drama. Drama actually makes me nauseous, you know what I'm saying? And I also don't think that it's ever important for people to know what I do, who I sleep with, who I date, right? But in this instance, it's very different, because as I said, there's so many people that are side-eyeing me, looking at me questionable about it. I mean, I've lost money, friendships, relationships behind it, and I think it's because people don't necessarily know the truth, but I've never done anything wrong. I love those people, literally, like my family. I don't have a bad thing to say about them. They are beautiful people. You know, when something starts affecting my life, and not only affecting my life, but affecting my wellness and my well-being, and also starts to block my heart space is blocked. I don't really have a choice but to express my truth. I actually sat down with Will and had a conversation due to the transformation from their marriage to life partnership that they've spoken on several times, and it, you know, not involving romanticism. He gave me his blessing. And I totally gave myself to that relationship for years of my life, you know? And I truly and really, really deeply loved and have a ton of love for her. I devoted myself to it. I gave my full self to it. So much so to the point that I can die right now and be okay with knowing that I truly gave myself to somebody.
Right, you did the right thing.
And I really loved a person. I experienced that. I know what that feels like, and some people never get that in this lifetime. So I know that I'm completely blessed. And this conversation is difficult because there's so much that it would be hard for people to understand. But once it starts to affect me and my livelihood, I have to speak up about my truth and stand on my 10 with anything that may come along with it.
Is it disappointing that she never addressed it to you? Because like you said, you lost out on opportunities. And if there's
I really can't even, I never even can get into the thought of that because I'm only responsible for myself, right? I'm only responsible for, you know, what I do.
So now that I took you guys to the present, let's go to the past of Will Smith being a guest star on the Red Table Talk and how they discuss about love, relationships, and how they view marriage. Let's take a look.
I really didn't want to get married, but...
We only got married because Gammy was crying.
Well, Gammy, this is what happened. It was almost as if Gammy was like, you have to get married, so let's talk about the wedding. It was almost like that.
And she completely just was like, that's not a reality where you're not married.
I was under so much pressure, you know, being a young actress, being young.
And
I was
just like, pregnant.
And I was just like, I didn't know what to do. But I just knew, I was like, I never wanted to be married.
I don't remember that. I remember feeling very strongly and wanting you guys to be married. I do remember that.
Yes.
But I don't remember your rejection of the idea of marriage. I remember the rejection of the idea of a wedding.
I didn't want a wedding either.
She didn't want it,
I was like, I don't want to get married. And now Gammy done gone to Will crying about, I don't want to have a wedding. And now I'm being forced to have a wedding. When really, I just wanted it to be the two of us on a mountain, because I was like, this is serious business.
Yeah.
I'm sorry that I didn't respect your wishes. It was totally a selfish, I'll never have that experience of my daughter getting married.
Right.
Because you were my only child. But that was so selfish.
It's okay. I mean,
it was the right call.
It was the right call.
I know it was the right call for you to marry, but not necessarily. That's what I'm talking about.
To have a wedding, yeah.
To have a wedding, because the wedding was horrible.
It was a horrible wedding.
It was a mess. Jada was sick. She was very unpleasant. Wouldn't cope. But she was sick.
She
didn't cooperate with
anything.
You
were 6 months pregnant at the wedding.
No, I was.
How many?
Three months.
Three months pregnant at the wedding.
Yeah, so she was having all that
morning
sickness.
My first trimester was
it was horrible.
And I was so upset that I had to have a wedding. Yeah. I was so pissed. I went crying down the freaking aisle.
I'll get married.
Cried the whole way.
And I was
down
like,
the aisle.
I was like, hey.
And
Will
was like, hey.
Yeah. Like, oh, she'd be all right. Don't worry.
Yeah, because that was one question I forgot to ask. She says that she never wanted to get married. Did you?
There wasn't a day in my life that I wanted anything other than being married and having a family.
Wow.
From, like,
well, thank the good Lord.
Literally 5 years old, I was picturing what my family would be.
Wow.
What was the fundamental bump about the idea of marriage in general that you were against?
I just never really agreed with the construct.
Exactly.
I just don't agree with it. Right. I never have. I still don't.
Yeah.
Till death do us part is real for me. It's just all of the rules and
it's
all
like
of the ideas.
It's like you're supposed to do this as a wife. You're supposed to do this. As a husband, you're supposed to do this.
Instead of really just...
And what you can't do.
Exactly.
And what you can't do, right.
Right? Because of this title, wife, is a
very difficult, the accepted conventional definition of wife.
Right. In the paradigm.
I'm not that.
Right.
So this is my opinion about the Will, Jada, and August Alsina situation. Now, let's just start off with Will and Jada's dynamic at the Red Table Talk. Now, as you guys heard in that flashback that I showed you guys at the Red Table Talk, Jada has expressed that she never wanted to get married as well as to have kids, but she just felt pressured because of her mother and Will. Whereas Will had this ideology of ever since that he was a kid that he wanted to have a wife, kids, and a perfect marriage. Whereas that he didn't really have that because in the beginning, he went on the set of A Different World to meet Jada, but then he met his first wife, Cherie, but then sadly they got divorced. And then after the divorce, then he started dating Jada and married her, but she got pregnant. Felt like it was the right thing to do to marry her because she was having his child. Now, that is to say this, that this relationship has been talked about for years. And for me to revisit this situation, because I did talk about August Alsina's Nunya. So as soon as this video is done, please make sure to check out that video so you guys can see how my perception of the current situation that's happening now to back then. So Jada's Pinkett Smith wanted to do Jada. Will felt like he wanted to never get divorced again, and he just felt like divorce wasn't an option and that he wanted to marry Jada for the simple fact of the relationship that he had prior and because of his family dynamic, that Will was basically saying that in his family, his father was abusive to his mother and he didn't want that for his future, as well as that he didn't want any profanity, as well as violence in the home. I do commend Will for trying to break a generational curse because he was in a family dynamic of violence and profanity. And he said at the Red Table Talk that he didn't want to bring that to his future family and his wife. So for Jada to be in this type of environment, because in the Red Table Talk, she has talked about her past, that her mother was addicted to drugs and being around profanity, that that's all she knew. But then as she got older, she got wiser. But there is a couple of things that I just didn't agree with this relationship. For instance, because Jada did not want to get married and she did not want to have kids, she felt pressured because of Will and her mother because she felt like it was the right thing to do. And she cried the whole wedding. That's what she said at the Red Table Talk. So that just makes me feel like if a person lets me know their expectations of how they want a relationship to go, whether it's a friendship or marriage, you know, it's my responsibility to either accept them for who they are, but not try to change them, or just walk away and let them know that this thing that you're doing is not comfortable for me. But in this situation, Will and Jada, even though they had a lot of differences, they tried to make it work. And in a result, you know, in present time, August Alsina has expressed his love for Jada as well as for the Will Smith family. So in this new interview that he did with Angela Yee, he has vocally said that Will has gave his blessing to August and Jada. And as a result, Jada did not feel the same way for August, which made August heartbroken. And for those that don't know, August grew up in a dysfunctional family as well, because for August, growing up in New Orleans, Louisiana, in his dysfunctional family, his father and stepfather was abusive. So for some people, they get into this pattern because of dysfunction, that that's all they know is dysfunction, or if they're very vulnerable, they'll just accept love from anybody because of the things that they're dealing with in life and they don't know how to cope with it themselves, that he just felt comfortable in the Smith family because of how perfect their relationship seemed on the outside, but in the inside looking out, he ended up being hurt because he developed feelings for a married woman. And as he said in the interview, he lost a lot of family, friends, and even business deals because of the speculations of the song Nanya, as well as people were assuming that August and Jada was a thing and that they were messing around. But personally, because he said that Will was okay with it, in his mind, he thought it was okay because he got the blessing from the husband. But me personally, in my personal opinion, I do not want to entertain married men. I don't want to entertain anybody that has a boyfriend to disrespect the relationship that I have with that person, because I just believe in monogamy. I don't believe in polygamy for the simple fact of whenever you invite somebody else in that relationship, that is always one person that's going to like the other person and cause the other person hurt. In this situation, that is August, because that Will gave the okay for him and Jada to have a fling, it ended up a result of August being heartbroken because he was developing feelings for Jada. People were seeing pictures of them on social media, as well as, you know, out and about, posting them and making it seem like that Jada was in an open relationship, because when you see the pictures of August and Jada, you don't see Will. Really raise an eyebrow of what kind of married man would let their wife do that. And that is called an open relationship. So in my personal opinion, I just believe that we should not idolize celebrity relationships or our personal relationships that we have in our lives, for the simple fact of you do not know what that relationship is going through and what the trials and tribulations that they have been through to get to where they're at today. Now, some people would make ultimatums if someone is doing something wrong, or they would just accept their flaws and just act like it never happened, which to me is really bad, because you have it in the back of your mind of either insecurities, or you feel like you're not good enough for that person, so you do these subliminal things. But you guys let me know in the comment section of how you guys feel about Will, Jada, and August Alsina's situation. Would you ever get into an open relationship? And what do you feel like will be the result of this situation? Hey, once you go, Ashanti Rashad, I just want to thank you so much for taking the time of watching this video. Don't forget to comment down below what you guys think of today's topic, as well as to turn on that bell notification and subscribe to my channel, so that way you don't miss any videos that I post. And follow me on social media. The links are underneath the description. See you next time. Peace.